Insurance, which actually, first quote is not bad, but realize because I'm older. So see, I passed my test at 23.
I left sort of coming back. I booked my flight to move back here a month before I actually did, just to make sure I didn't want to stay there.
Yeah.
Give myself a laugh when I get a bit older.
The next
but actually, I decided a week before I moved down to so I get really gave it out a week. So I gave myself a week fixed time. So first I was like, I probably won't do it. And then like a week later, I was like, yeah, to do it. So the week later, I was like, okay.
But then how does it work? Oh, I suppose it's partly EU, so work is hard.
Yeah, you work
in the EU.
And then after that, you're supposed to get a health insurance.
Oh, what's that all about?
Because for 4 months you're covered by
Oh, right, okay, right, yeah, I see. Because they don't have, like, what we have. Yeah, yeah, okay, well, that makes sense.
If you live in there, then you have to pay for your own health insurance. It's €100 a month.
Yeah, but still, it's not, is it law that you have to get it? Oh.
And you have to register as well. So after 4 months, you've got to register to get healthcare. But I didn't. But that, so many people live over there and don't have to.
Yeah.
So many people do it.
I suppose it would only fall down if you needed care, and then if you needed care, so you'd have to fund it.
So my friend Dave, he's been living there for 5 years, and
oh, no.
He didn't register for 4 years.
£4,000
a year. But they won't like kick you out.
No.
You just have to pay back for the time that you've been there.
Yeah. And I guess you'll get time. Yeah.
You have to register.
Yeah.
Yeah,
sure.
It's okay, but I'm going to use
that for this one. Do you remember that Albert?
No, I remember Georgie used to talk about
this.
Yeah,
I can't remember
why.
He's just moved off to Iceland.
Oh my god,
you just go and live with his boyfriend. And I was like, I knew there was a man. Like, I was like, it was a guy.
He
my boyfriend looks like coolie, so. That's what he is.
Yeah, no thanks.
See, I keep getting, texts from Premier Let's, like, there's a flat in
the area.
I'm like, thanks, girl.
Can you move it out?
No. Not anytime soon.
It's not even that. I've got money.
I've got probably half a deposit. I've got probably about 5-6,000.
Yeah.
But I can't get a mortgage on my own. I'd rather buy. I'd rather just go and buy somewhere.
I thought to search for maximum option gets about £80,000 or so.
And like, literally, my parents hadn't even left him. They dropped him. They got him to bed, and he started to feel sick because he does have anxiety. And he just got really unwell. He was like, I can't do it. I've got to come home. So they just brought him straight back again. And then my dad had to go up the next week and get all his stuff. It's not really, we're all like, yeah, it's fine.
So if you imagine the bay is like here.
So yeah, no, I'd love to move down there.
It is really
I
nice.
I think it's either. Still on here.
The original one. Because that's the three bedroom one for £800, but there's a two bedroom one we looked at. I really loved it. I really wanted to go for it. And then John was like, I can't. He was like, I'm really not ready. And I was like, it's fine. Like, I'm not going to make it. But yeah, it was a shame, it was a nice place. And it had a roof terrace, which was communal, but none of the other flats used it because you've got your direct door to it from that flat.
Yeah.
And I was like, I want to live with that. But yeah. As well, like, it's hard because White lives up in Crawley and works up there, and he doesn't like, he's like, oh, we're not really moving. I'm like, yeah, because I'm going to give it 2 years, so yeah, don't rush with me. That's fine. I can't be bothered with them, they're such children. Like, oh, look, I might want to do this, which is horrible.
My ex in Amsterdam, he was 28 when we got together, he's 29 now.
They don't grow up.
Children.
They don't grow up.
Man, child.
Honestly, like, I'll say to White, I'll be like, you know, why don't we think about it? He's really small.
You know, I don't know if we're ready. I'm like, so cute.
Like, 24, they go south and move out. Like,
yeah, exactly.
Crack on.
Yeah. With me and my ex in Amsterdam.
Gosh,
yeah.
It was tea now, it was more different.
Well,
she
was so close.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I've never seen this table on the bottom.
Oh, really?
It was really cool.
It's been a bit.
Yeah.
There's a table.
They come in with cheap coffees like
Stuart. Oh, you do on all that buses, so it's terribly advanced, it's bright.
All together. It's just one of those massive, like, issues.
What number are we on?
She
gets talking to us.
But like my friend at work, like she's trans, and her partner's trans.
Yes, it's ended up with a child.
She came into work, and she came into work, and I brought her out there with a mum. And like we weren't that close then, but like he's such a knob, and he's now falling. So like she kicked him out, so now he's moved back in with his ex in London.
So the other cats,
but they're not together. It's just a mess. Like he's so much fun. She's like, oh, I love him. And I'm like, no, you don't. You just don't want to be alone. I don't realise how lucky I am. I understand it. You know, people will be in there all day. Josh is very uncontrolled.
The next stop
is very controlled in his actions.
He rushed.
I like it. I need a new hat. Tropical.